Welcome to this short reflection for Palm Sunday. It's going to be a mixture of music and listening and watching part of the Palm Story Sunday from Mark's Gospel, along with some prayers. But let us just pause and remember all those who are struggling with the global pandemic. And as we have been doing over the last few weeks, let's join together in prayer, in solidarity and in remembrance for all those who have died of COVID-related illnesses and those who grieve their loss. Let us pray. God of all, we cry out to you for help. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Protect us, Lord, and be with us, especially those of us most vulnerable. During this coronavirus, move us to reach out in love to our neighbours near and far, so that the humble may be exalted, the hungry filled with good things. Grant us the courage not to rush back to our old ways, but to rebuild our world together, creating foundations of justice with equality and peace for all. So, with those thoughts in our hearts, we listen to our first piece of music, which is Hosanna to the King of Kings. Not necessarily the version that you might be familiar with, but a version that reminds us of just who Jesus is and just why there was that triumphal procession on that first Palm Sunday. Let us listen.
Thank you.
So, as we come to reflect on Palm Sunday, we see and hear once again the gospel account of that triumphal entry into Jerusalem according to Mark. And as you listen and as you watch, ponder where you would be in that crowd. Would you be one of those who would be standing at the forefront cheering enthusiastically? Would you be somewhere in the middle, quizzically wondering what was going on, intrigued but not necessarily wanting to get involved? Or would you be standing at the back, critical, not believing that anything could change? Or perhaps you're in all three of those places and different parts of you are still in those three different places. And that is okay. But perhaps as you listen and you watch, ask Jesus to inspire you to be at the front of the crowd, welcoming him not only into Jerusalem, but into your heart. Let's walk.
As they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethphage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and just as you enter it, you will find a colt tied there, which no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you doing this?' say, 'The Lord needs it and will send it back here shortly.'" They went and found a colt outside in the street, tied at a doorway. As they untied it, some people standing there asked, "What are you doing untying that colt?" They answered as Jesus had told them to, and the people let them go. When they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks over it, he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, while others spread branches they had cut in the fields. Those who went ahead and those who followed shouted, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" Jesus entered Jerusalem and went into the temple courts. He looked around at everything, but since it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. The next day, as they were leaving Bethany, Jesus was hungry. Seeing in the distance a fig tree in leaf, he went to find out if it had any fruit. When he reached it, he found nothing but leaves, because it was not the season for figs. Then he said to the tree, "May no one ever eat fruit from you again." And his disciples heard him say it. On reaching Jerusalem, Jesus entered the temple courts. And began driving out those who were buying and selling there. He overturned the tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves, and would not allow anyone to carry merchandise through the temple courts. And as he taught them, he said, "Is it not written, 'My house will be called a house of prayer for all nations'? But you have made it a den of robbers." The chief priests and the teachers of the law heard this and began looking for a way to kill him, for they feared him, because the whole crowd was amazed at his teaching. When evening came, Jesus and his disciples went out of the city. In the morning, as they went along, they saw the fig tree withered from the roots. Peter remembered and said to Jesus, "Rabbi, look, the fig tree you cursed has withered." "Have faith in God," Jesus answered. "Truly, I tell you, if anyone says to this mountain, 'Go, throw yourself into the sea,' and does not doubt in their heart, but believes that what they say will happen, it will be done for them. Therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have received it, and it will be yours. And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive them, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you your sins."
So, as we have heard that very well-known account of the entry of Jesus into Jerusalem, I just want to encourage us to continue to ponder and reflect on just where our journey of faith is taking us. And perhaps in the challenging times that we have, to just spend a brief moment just pondering and praying. So we're going to listen to a piece of music with some pictures. It's "Be Still and Know That I Am God." And then after that, I'm going to lead us in some prayers for Palm Sunday. So let's listen. Thank you. Let us pray. Holy Father, as Christ entered Jerusalem, let him enter our lives. Let the King of Glory come in, that he may rule in our hearts, and that we may offer our love and lives to him. Through the same Christ our Lord, who offered his life for us and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. Christ, broken on the cross, we draw near to you. We come with broken promises and broken dreams. We come as a church divided and not at unity in itself. Yet we seek through you to share in salvation and to bring others to your saving love. Lord, as you give yourself to us, may we give ourselves for others. Lord of the cross, we come to you. We pray for our nation, and we pray for nations divided against nations. And we particularly pray at this time for a coming together around the global pandemic and the distribution of vaccines. We pray for all peoples that are not at peace with their neighbours. We pray for all places where there is injustice and abuse of power. We pray for all places of discord and dissatisfaction. Bless, O Lord, the work of the United Nations, the World Health Organization, and those international aid agencies, that they may work together in the cause of peace and justice. Lord of the cross, we come to you. May we accept you, O Christ, as our King. Let your rule begin in our hearts and homes. We pray for homes where there is discord, for homes darkened by deceit and betrayal, for homes where loyalty and love are divided. And in a moment of quiet, we pray for our communities across the Fellside team. Lord of the cross, we come to you. Lord, be with all who have a difficult week ahead, the scorned and the rejected, those who face insult or degradation. We remember those who will be persecuted for faith or a matter of principle, for those whose spirits will be broken this week. And we pray for those who are brokenhearted and those struggling with broken relationships. We pray for all who are suffering from any kind of breakdown. And in a moment of quiet, we pray for those who are on our hearts this day. Lord of the cross, we come to you. We give thanks for the holy martyrs of God, for all who have suffered for others and for truth, for those who sacrificed for us and are now at rest. Through your cross and passion, may we share with them in glory. Lord of the cross, we come to you. So as we come towards the end of this reflection, may we find in the crucified Christ the forgiveness of our sins, the renewing power of love, and the promise of eternal life. And the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be with you, be with all those you love, be with all those for whom you pray, this day and always. Amen. And as a short reflection comes to an end, we hear the famous Palm Sunday hymn, ride on, your majesty. God bless. Bye for now.